I've seen this, and this here has got to be the definition of a fool. This is what we have in our government. It's called a fool. And I know the Bible says not to call anybody a fool, but even Jesus Christ would call this woman a fool. This is an idiot right here. Definition of an idiot, and if you don't believe it, I'm gonna play it for you. Here, listen to what Hillary Clinton says. This is a woman that wants to be the next president.
Yes. This is what we call smart power, using every possible tool and partner to advance peace and security, leaving no one on the sidelines, showing respect even for one's enemies, trying to understand and, insofar as psychologically possible, empathize with their perspective and point of view, helping to define the problems, determine the solutions. That is what we believe in the 21st century will change the prospects for peace.
What? We have to empathize with our enemies. I'm going to go back and show you. This is Fox headlines. Sympathy for the enemy. Now, I'm going to tell you what's going to happen if by some stupid chance the American people was to elect me president. You see that guy? You see him right there in that black thing? I would empathize. I would invite him to the White House. At which time, I would take one of the Marines' swords away from him. You know, the Marines that guard the White House. I would take his sword, chop that dude's head off right on the White House lawn, and stick it on a pole out there in front of everybody. Give them a little taste of their own medicine. That's the only thing these people will ever understand, is show them a little biblical justice. That's right. These people are killing Christians. They are beheading Christians by the hundreds. And any church in America that is empathizing with these people need to go over there and have their head chopped off. Because I tell you what, right now, there is certain parts of the Bible that even Jesus said, you have to swap in your sword or swap in your cloak for a sword. Now, it's time for the Christians in this country to take their cloaks, swap it in for a sword, and stick their sword up this guy's rectum. That's right. This guy right here holding that flag needs a sword stuck up his rectum. And if anybody doesn't like that, they can kiss my big fat ass.